Okay, let us begin the chapter number one, Tom and the Fence. As I said, it consists of 8 chapters. Now we are going to learn chapter number one. So remember, every chapter has its own title. Every chapter has a title. So let us deal with the chapter number one, Tom and the Fence. Tom, Tom, there was no answer. Where is that boy? Tom. Aunt Polly looked under the bed, but she only found a cat. Tom, she cried. Then she heard a noise behind her. A small girl ran fast and stopped with her hand. In the first paragraph, we can see that Aunt Polly is introduced. And Aunt Polly, an old woman, went into the bedroom of Tom and tried to wake him up and call by his name. When she want to find her, she just search under the bed whether Tom is under the bed or on the bed, but he was not there. She just found the cat only. So that's why she cried again, Tom. Then she heard a noise behind her. While Aunt Polly was waking up Tom, a small girl running behind her. She is none other than Tom's sister, Mary. Okay, what are you doing, Tom? She asked. Nothing, nothing. Look at your hand and your mouth. I told you not to eat the jam. So here, after a few minutes, Tom appeared before her. And she asked immediately, Aunt Polly asked her a question. And what Tom was doing there. And then Tom replied, so I'm doing nothing here. And she asked to look at Tom's hand. So here she already told many times that not to eat jam in the early morning especially. Then Aunt tries to warn him while Aunt Polly was trying to warn him. Tom played a trick on her. He played a prank on her by saying that, see, oh Aunt Polly, look behind you. Then the old lady looked at Tom and ran away. So this is the trick generally Tom plays on her aunt. So by this we can understand Tom is mischievous and he always plays tricks on Aunt Polly. That's why Aunt Polly wants to put him in discipline. Okay, let us continue. Aunt Polly was surprised and then she laughed. The lady looked around and Tom ran away. She just checked whether Tom said the fact or not. For knowing that, she turned back. But there was no one there. And meanwhile, Tom slipped from that place. Slipped away from that place. Thus, Tom played a trick on her Aunt Polly. I never learned Tom always plays tricks on me. She accepts. She agrees that Tom always plays tricks on Aunt Polly. You need to remember because this particular paragraph is given as a comprehension at the end of the lesson. I never learned, I love Tom. He is my sister's child. So here, the relation between Tom and Aunt Polly is mentioned. How Tom is related to Aunt Polly? Tom is Aunt Polly's sister's son. Aunt Polly's sister's son. Got it? And she is dead. So we can understand. Now, Mr. Tom is a parentless child, but living under the guidance of under the guardianship of, under the protection of Aunt Polly. but it is not easy to look after him. Tomorrow is a Saturday and there is no school. So it is a convention that Americans follow. Americans take 2 days leave in a week. But here in India we have only Sundays treated as a holiday. But there they take 2 days as holidays, on Saturday and on Sunday. But Tom must work tomorrow. He hates work, but he must do it. So here another quality of Tom is revealed here. Tom doesn't want to work. He always prefers to play. He always prefers to play with friends or doing exciting things. Got it? So that's why here Aunt Polly decided to allot some work on Saturday, as there is no school on Saturday. He wants to punish him, but actually it is not a punishment, it is a work. So because Tom doesn't work, so but Tom must work tomorrow. He hates work, but he must do it. So finally Aunt Polly, he decided to make Tom to do some work on Saturday. Okay, let us see the third paragraph. Tom lived in the small village of St. Petersburg with his Aunt Polly, his brother Sid and his sisters Mary. Now Tom's family is introduced. How many members are there in Tom's family? Four. Who are they? The first one is Aunt Polly, his guardian, and his brother Sid and his sister Mary. Okay, let us move on the further information. The summer evenings were long, and in the evenings Tom liked walking around the village. One evening he saw a big boy in front of him. The boy was a stranger. So Tom was surprised because he did not see new people often. So the boy had very nice expensive clothes. So here there is another habit which Tom has is revealed here, that is in the summer evenings, particularly in the every evening he wants to roam around the village. Tom liked walking around the village in the evenings. So one evening while he was on his routine, he saw a stranger. Generally in the village of St. Petersburg we often rarely sees new people. So that's why he takes interest on him. So the boy had very nice and expensive clothes. The boy looks clean and with new dress. So what are the articles he has worn? He has got shoes, a new shirt and a tie, and it is not Sunday. So why Tom is saying it is not Sunday? Because particularly children wear new clothes or clean clothes on Sundays, because as they have the habit of going church along with their parents on that day. So that's why he said this. It is not Sunday. Tom thought, my clothes are old and ugly. Tom looked at him. The boy looked at Tom. Tom did not like him. Finally, he said, I can beat you. So here, Tom doesn't like the dress and the shoes what the boy wears. So that's why he wants to fight with him. As Tom's clothes were dirty and ugly, he doesn't like the new dress that are worn by the stranger, a new boy. That's why he provoked him to fight with him. Provoke means using words to manipulate others to fight with us. Okay, so here the provoking words are exchanged between the two boys. They are, I can beat you, so why don't you try, said the boy. And here we can understand the boy is also ready to fight with Tom. Tom. Well, can I said Tom? No, you can't. Yes, I can. There was silence. Now both are ready. Then Tom said, you are afraid. The boy said, you are afraid. I am not afraid, said Tom. Yes, you are. But he is again saying the same thing. Tom is afraid of new boy. But Tom says, I am not. There was more silence. Then Tom pushed the boy and the boy pushed Tom. Soon they were on the ground. Tom pulled the boy's hair and hit him hard. They both fought a lot. The boy was angry and started crying. So a little fight took place between the boys. And here Tom dominated with his punches and he hit the boy, stranger boy, hardly. Then he started crying. Then here Tom stopped fighting and said, stop, stop. Now that we'll teach you something, said Tom. So this is enough for you. With my punches, you learn something. This is the lesson I want to teach you because I didn't like your dress. Now let's move on to this next one. Tom arrived home late and was dirty. When Aunt Polly saw his dirty clothes, she thought, oh, what can I do with this boy? So here, the things what is done by the Tom is not liked by Aunt Polly. So there is another naughty thing Tom has done here is, he came home late. He came home late because he fought with a boy. That's why. And that too, already before then, the clothes of Tom's were dirty and ugly. And after that fight, his clothes become more dirty. And here, Aunt Polly didn't like see him coming late and his clothes are in rags or dirty. That's why he shows his angry by saying, what can I do with this boy? Tomorrow is Saturday and he must work. So for this reason also, she wants to allot some work to Tom. Saturday morning was beautiful and sunny. It was summer and the world was happy. As it was summer, children have holidays generally. And all the children in the St. Petersburg play happily there. And Tom sat in front of the fence and looked at it. It was 30 yards long and 9 feet high. And he was unhappy. It's Saturday. I must paint this long fence. So this is what the work allotted to Tom by Aunt Polly as a punishment. So what was the punishment given by Tom? What was the work allotted to Tom by Aunt Polly? She wanted him to paint the fence with white color. To paint the fence with white color. So that is the work. He should do painting there. He should paint the fence. A fence is a cloth or a chain that is, or a wall made of bricks or made of wood as a compound wall. That is called fence. Here Tom has to paint the fence in white color. That was the punishment or work, whatever it is, allotted to Tom as he was mischievous, as he did two mistakes. That is, one is he played a prank on her, and the second one is he came late to home with dirty clothes. Okay, let us continue. So here his disagreement is showing. He's sighing. It's Saturday and I must paint this long fence. All my friends will laugh at me, he thought. So as Aunt Polly said, he doesn't like to work. And if he does this painting, his friends may laugh at him. So those are the thoughts that are running in the mind of Tom. And let's move on to the next para. He put his long brush in the white paint and started painting. He stopped and looked at his work. So at last, with disagreement, with unlikeliness, he started painting. He just dipped the brush in the bucket and started painting. But he stopped and looked at his work. Then he continued painting. See, he paints the fence continuously by taking breaks. When he pays the brush, when he applies the brush on the fence, then he stops. And he just goes back and see this work and come forward. And then again, he put the brush in the bucket and paint again. So this is what Tom is doing. So it is showing that he is not interested in painting. So after a few minutes, he had a great idea. As we said, Tom is a mischievous boy with active imagination. His mind acts very sharply. What was the idea that has framed in the mind of Tom? He continued painting the fence. He saw his friend Ben Rogers. Who is the friend? Ben Rogers. While he was painting, he saw his friend Ben Rogers coming towards in the street. And Ben had an apple in his hand. So he came to look at the fence. "You are working for your aunt," said Ben. Tom said nothing. He continued painting. So then Ben Rogers asked with a doubt, "You are painting a fence for your aunt. Is it right, Tom?" Tom said, "No, nothing. I am not doing anything." He continued painting. He said that, "I am not doing anything work, but he doing work. What should we understand here? See, I am going swimming, but you can't come with me. You are working." Then Ben Rogers told Tom that he is going for swimming. Actually, he came there to invite him to swim in the river along with Tom, but Tom is not able to come with him as he is painting the fence. So this is what Ben Rogers said to Tom. "Do you call this work?" asked Tom. Then Tom asked Ben Rogers, "Do you call this work?" "Yes, of course, it is a work," Ben Rogers said. "So everyone says painting a fence is your work. You are me also." "You are painting a fence," said Ben. Then he said, "You are painting a fence, that's why it is called work. Maybe it is work, but it is not." He played with the words. Maybe it is a work, maybe it is not. Somewhat it is work, somewhat it is not. So there is a confusion. "I like it," said Tom. "I can swim every day, but I can't paint a fence every day." So he said, he is trying to manipulate him. He is applying a trick on his friend by saying this, "I can swim every day, but I can't paint a fence. But I can't paint a fence," because painting a fence is done every year or for every 6 months or something. It takes long time. But the swimming is a hobby we can do every day. That is what Tom said to Rogers, Ben Rogers. Here, see the picture, and I'm continuing. Ben watched Tom. He painted slowly and carefully. He often stopped and moved back from the fence as he did in the beginning. He just paint a brush and goes back and see his work and come forward, dip the brush in the bucket and paint on the fence. He painted slowly and carefully. He often stopped to move back from the fence. He looked at his work and smiled. He is pretending to paint, but actually not. Ben was suddenly interested in the fence and said, how he got interest? By watching the actions what Tom did there. Suddenly Ben Rogers took interest in painting. There he Ben Rogers asked Tom, "Let me paint a little, Tom." Tom thought for a moment and said, "I'm sorry, Ben. Aunt Polly wants me to do it because I'm very good at painting. My brother Sid wanted to do it, but he's not good at painting." So here, by these words, we can understand how a cunning fellow Tom is. He's manipulating. He's just applying a reverse psychology on Ben Rogers by saying that Aunt Polly only gave this work to me as I was a good painter. I am good at painting. Of course, my brother also asked to paint this fence, but Aunt Polly did not allow him to paint because my brother was not good at painting. By hearing these words, he took more interest. Who took more interest in painting? Ben Rogers. So this is what we understand here. He started pleading, "Oh, please, Tom, please, can I paint? I am good at painting too. I am also a good painter. If you give me a chance, I'll paint it. Here you can have some of my apple." Here Ben Rogers tried to bribe. He already have an apple, but he wants to give it now for doing work. How funny thing it is. "No, Ben, I can't. Then take all of my apple." First, Ben Rogers asked Tom to take some only. But still, Tom did not allow him to paint. And then he wants to give the total, the entire apple to, he offered the total apple, the whole apple to Tom. So that is what manipulation, that is what reverse psychology. So here Tom is cunning, as Tom is playing a trick on Ben Rogers. So Tom was happy, but he did not smile. In inner he is happy, but on the outside he is not showing his happiness. He gave Ben the brush and sat down to eat the apple. So how intelligent Tom is. He gave Ben the brush and sat down to eat the apple. Tom's other friends came by. At first they laughed at him, but soon they all wanted to paint the fence. The same trick is applied to other people also, other friends also who came by. So Billy Fresher gave Tom a kite, and John Miller bought him a dead rat. His other friends gave him an old knife, a cat with one eye, and an old blue bottle and an old key and other interesting things. His friends painted the fence. Tom now had a lot of interesting things. He went back home. So thus he made his friends do his work by them. So if you see the picture, we can observe. So Tom is eating apple. The boy who wore a blue dress by holding an apple in his hand, and Ben Rogers is painting, and the others are also observing. So that is the scene we can imagine through the picture. So soon the other people here, he just watching the interesting things what were given to him as bribe for doing work. He went back home. "Aunt Polly, can I go to play now?" So after finishing his painting, he just go to Aunt Polly and asked her permission to go and play. When Aunt Polly saw the beautiful white fence, she was happy. She gave Tom a big apple and said, "Yes, go and play, but don't come home late. That is what the end of the chapter number 1. So in this chapter we can see the introduction of the family members of Tom. There are 4 members in the family. They are Aunt Polly, Tom himself, and his brother Sid, and his sister Mary. And there is another important thing from this chapter we should remember is Tom always plays tricks on Aunt Polly. And then Tom is a cunning fellow. How can we understand? He is just applying a reverse psychology on Ben Rogers and other friends to do his work, to do the work for him, which was allotted by Aunt Polly for him only as a punishment. So he knows how to escape from the punishment, and he knows how to manipulate others to do work for him. So these are the three important things we need to remember about the chapter 1, Tom and the Fence. Now let us see the comprehension passages regarding this chapter number 1. Okay, let us see the comprehension passages, that what we call textual passages. As I explained you, a comprehension passage is given from one of the 8 chapters and it carries 5 marks. It is just like what you do with the unseen comprehension. But the problem while doing textual passages, textual comprehension, is not all the answers are visible in the given text or passage. We need to have an idea on the paragraph, and we should have an idea about the connecting paragraphs, preceded paragraph and succeeded paragraph. That means before the paragraph and after the paragraph. Sometimes the questions may ask on the characters also. So that's why it is better to do paragraphs after reading every chapter, because we have some information already stored in our mind regarding the chapter 1. So in this textbook, 2 comprehension passages are taken from the chapter number 1. So let us see what the paragraph number 1 consists of and what are the questions that are asked regarding the paragraph number 1. Okay, let us see. I am showing you. So what are you doing, Tom? She asked. Nothing. Look at your hand and your mouth. I told you not to eat jam. Aunt Polly looked behind. The old lady looked and Tom ran away. So this is the paragraph at the beginning of the chapter 1. While Aunt Polly searching for Tom, and there he played a trick on Aunt Polly, and how Tom escaped from that room. Let us see. Right. Tom lived in a village of St. Petersburg with his Aunt Polly, his brother Sid and his sister Mary. The summer evenings were long, and in the evenings Tom liked walking around the village. One evening he saw a big boy in front of him. The boy was a stranger. So not the complete information is given. Just the first paragraph is given completely and the second paragraph is given with half information. Right. Let us see what are the questions are given. I am reading the first question. What are you doing, Tom? She asked. So in this speech, actually the sentence which are put in the quotation marks are called direct speech. In the direct speech, this is the sentence by Aunt Polly. Here the question is, what are you doing, Tom? She asked. Whom does she refers to? In the question, a pronoun is given, she. Here the pronoun She refers whom? She refers whom? Whom does she refers to? Who said that sentence? It is said by Aunt Polly. So here in the first question, the pronoun she refers Aunt Polly. So you can write the answer exactly opposite the question number one. If not, you can copy the questions in your notes and write the answers with them. Got it? So who does she refers to? Who said that word? Who said that words? Aunt Polly. And see the second one. Why was Aunt Polly surprised and laughed? Why was Aunt Polly surprised and laughed? See, in the first paragraph, line number 3, Aunt Polly was surprised, then she laughed. I never learned. Here, you need to write the answer on your own by understanding the sentence. But don't copy the sentence directly from the paragraph, because it may not be the right answer. Of course, we did the same thing while we doing comprehension passages in the first year. But as far as the textual passage is concerned, that trick is not applied here. So what is the question asked here? Why was Aunt Polly surprised and laughed? We should tell the reason why she has laughed and why she was surprised. The reason is Tom played a trick on her and she could not realize that, we can say it, she could not realize that Tom played a trick on her by saying, what did Tom say? Oh, Aunt Polly, look behind you. Oh, Aunt Polly, look behind you. That is the answer you need to write. The answer is, I'm saying the answer again. Why was Aunt Polly surprised and laughed? The reason is, she could not realize, she could not understand, she could not realize that Tom played a trick on her by saying, you need to write the sentence, oh Aunt Polly, look behind you. So this is what the answer you must write for the question number 2. Do we have the same answer what I said in the paragraph? No. So that's why it is very important to understand the gist, main idea of the paragraph or the chapter. Then only we can answer the questions. Otherwise, we may write wrong answers. So be careful while answering textual passages like this. So let us move on to the third question. Question number 3. State true or false. The Aunt Polly is always tricked by Tom. This is the statement. You need to write whether the statement is true or false. Aunt Polly is always tricked by Tom. So we have learned in the chapter, I told you that I was always tricked by him. She said directly. So that's why it is a true statement. You can write true. Next, let's move on to the fourth one. How are Tom and Aunt Polly related? I told you. How they are related? Who is Tom to Aunt Polly? How he is related? Tom is Aunt Polly's sister's son. Tom is Aunt Polly's sister's son. This is the answer you need to write there. So how are Tom and Aunt Polly related? Tom is her sister's son, or Tom is Aunt Polly's sister's son. Okay, let's move on. Do we have the same answer in the same sentence? Yes. See the fourth one. He is my sister's child. She is dead. I love Tom, my sister's child. So from this sentence, we can write the correct answer. But don't write that directly. And let's move on to the fifth one. How many family members does Tom have? Who are they? It's a very easy question to answer. So I told you, how many members are there? 4 members are there in Tom's family. Tom, Aunt Polly, his brothers Sid and his sister Mary. So these are the 4 members that are living in Tom's family. Who are they? For this question, we need to write their names also. How many members? 4. So 4 is the answer for the first one. And the extended question is, who are they? Here we need to write how Tom, Aunt Polly, Sid and Mary. These are the 4 members who lived in the Tom's family. Got it? So this is the way you need to answer comprehension passages from non-detailed text. So we can simply call it textual passage. We can simply call it textual passage. Let us see second example, second paragraph that is also taken from the same chapter, Tom and the Fence. So here, I'm going swimming, but you can't come with me. You are working. And said Ben, do you call this work? Asked Tom. Of course it's work. You are painting a fence, said Ben. So we can simply understand that in this paragraph, Ben Rogers were tricked by Tom. And how cunningly Tom gives his work, let the Ben Rogers do the work that is allotted for him. See here, we will see the cunning nature of Tom, how he hand over the work to Ben Rogers, and also he takes the apple from Ben also, but he didn't take forcibly, but he let him to give his apple as a gift. That is what happened here. So here also 5 questions. The first one is, what is the work Tom was doing? Painting a fence. So we can take the answer from the second line. See this? Of course it's work. You are painting a fence. So we can write the same sentence. Tom is painting a fence. Okay. Let's see the second one. Was Tom really enjoying his work? No, he was not enjoying his work. Do we have any hints whether he enjoys the work? He just pretends to enjoy, but not enjoying directly. If he enjoys the work, why did he allot the work to his friend? So we can write the answer for the second question is, no, Tom is not enjoying his work. He just acts as he enjoying work when Ben Rogers watch him. It is a trick. So, but the answer is, you can write no, because it was a yes or no question. Let's move on to the third question. Who was suddenly interested in painting the fence? Who took interest? Who came to Tom while he was fencing for the first? Ben Rogers. Here, his name was given as Ben. You can write Ben Rogers or Ben. Ben is enough. And let's see the question number 4. What did Ben offer Tom to give him a chance to paint the fence? So in the picture we have seen, he holds a fruit. What is that fruit? And the same fruit is offered to Tom for giving the work, for allowing him to paint. So here we can write the answer as, Ben offered Tom an apple. So you can simply write an apple. Got it? Hope you understand. And let's move on to the last one. So there is a question of, it's a multiple choice question, and 3 answers are given here. What do you think of Tom from the above incident? So I told you, the character of the Tom briefly. Here, what do you think of the Tom from the above incident? Because his character changes according to the... He shows some of his good qualities, some of his bad qualities according to the context. From the above passage, what can we understand about the character of Tom? That is, option A, Tom is hardworking. Option B, Tom is plain-natured. Tom is cunning. So see, take the first one, Tom is hardworking. No, not at all, because he hates work. And take the second one, Tom is plain-natured. No, if he is plain-natured, why did he apply tricks on? Why did he tease others? So the option C is correct. Here we need to write the answer. We need to write the select the answer C as the right one. So what do you think of Tom there from the above incident means Tom is cunning. So this is the way we need to answer the questions that are given under the paragraph. If you go through the chapters again, you can write them very easily. Here you need not to mug up. Mug up means by heart. So if you listen to the class carefully and understand it well, it is very easy for you to write the answers for the questions. So because we have a paragraph in the question paper from one of these 8 chapters. Got it? So this is the way we should answer them. Okay? I hope you understand well. And write your answers in your notes again, and it will be very easy to remember or answer some of the answers that are directly given in the paragraph. You may underline them. But my advice is just write the answers again as the questions if you have the textbook. If you do not have the textbook, you just copy the questions. You just copy the questions from this video and write the answers against the questions. That's all. Hope you understand. Thank you.